to review the parade. At the arrival of the Chief Minister, everyone is requested to rise from the seat and remain standing while the national anthem is being rendered.
Dina, dah hati anda ini, tadi Allah follow kiri, tu bisi deh, we'll switch over to Nian, okay? Nian,
tiada hati anda, okay, tiada hati anda, tiada Allah starting dah kerjibo, hari ini guna, abni arah ini tiada kerjibo hidup ini, macam kamera harus switch over kiri.
Excuse me, apa lagi awak ni?
Ladies and gentlemen, the DGP Nagaland will now review the parade.
Thank you.
The program highlights for the 75th Independence Day 2021 are as follows. At 600 hours, hoisting of national flag in all government offices, institutions, public and private buildings. At 850 hours, review of parade by DGP Nagaland. At 900 hours, the Honorable Chief Minister will arrive, hoist the national flag, take the lustrous salute and inspect the parade, followed by the address by the Honorable Chief Minister. Presentation of awards and march past. This will be followed by the cultural presentation and entertainment segment performed by various artists and cultural troops.
At 100 hours, governors at home program will begin. Thereafter, the evening program at Secretary Plaza will be held. 1600 hours, prize distribution, and at 1630 hours, band display by Nagaland Police Central Police Band, BTS, followed by 14 Assam Rifle 5 Band, then followed by the beginning of retreat.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Chief Minister has arrived. Kindly rise from your seats. You may be seated.
This morning we have 11 conditions for the ceremony of Parat. Have a parent among us, you need to come out to the IC, Shreemati, Madam Balatibi, Assistant Commander, 15 and FD IR. 7 BSF. IR Bahila Battalion, Special Task Force STF, Home Guards and Civil Defense and STRF.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the program for the celebration of the 75th Independence Day 2021 at Nagaland Civil Secretariat, NASA. I now invite the Chief Minister to kindly deliver his speech.
It is a momentous day in the history of our country, and we are indeed honored to be a part of this occasion. We commemorate a milestone in a joyous manner, and even as we celebrate Azadi ka Amrit, Mahotsav, meaning nuclear nectar of freedom festival, we are once again reminded of all the freedom fighters whose sacrifices brought freedom to our people. We salute them. Our nation since its birth has been moving ahead with determination in every domain, and today it has come to secure its place among the most important influential nations in the world. When we started, however, our nation had difficult challenges, and in many respects, it was very way behind other countries of the world. A large majority of our people suffered from poverty and hunger. Serious disparities exist among various sections of our people, as well as between the different regions of the country. The economy was weak, there was lack of infrastructure, and all the human development indexes were also very low. In fact, on many indicators, we started as a weak and poor nation. However, in spite of such steep challenges, our people had the will and the perseverance to prevail over all these obstacles. And unitedly, we have all worked and marched together to take our nation to a position that we all could be now proud of. Today, as we look around, we cannot but marvel at the tremendous progress that we have made as a nation, be it economy, infrastructure, defense, human resources, or science and technology. Above all, we have made a marked improvement in the quality of life of our people. While always remaining steadfast in the ideals of justice, liberty, equality, and fraternity, India is today a respectable and contributing nation towards the cause of humanity amongst the community of nations. India has dozens of satellites in space, providing service to several countries. We have emerged as a responsible nuclear power nation. Our brave and disciplined armed forces are standing up for the cause of nonviolence through the peacekeeping forces in our and our ancient knowledge of Ayurveda and yoga have been internationally acclaimed. Made in India, COVID-19 vaccines are helping dozens of countries around the world. Even as India is now chair of the United Nations Security Council, as the world's largest democratic nation, India continues to make valuable contributions towards the progress of humanity and for the cause of freedom on an international scale. Our state has also been an equal partner with all other states of the nation in a journey that all have been making on the path of development and prosperity. As we look at the decades since statehood, we could see how we have evolved as a confident state and developed and progressed in every field. Nagaland is contributing and participating member of India's union building process. We have given the country our best daughters and sons
in the journey of India's progress in multiple fields. As our brave soldiers have fought the country's enemies and guarded our borders with courage and valor. Artists, musicians, and cultural ambassadors from our state Nagaland have added to the vibrant diversity of the country and in the field of public affairs, meritocracy, democracy, sports, and the four estates. The citizens of Nagaland have served the country with exemplary distinction. Indeed, even as the country crosses the landmark of 75 years, it is also an occasion to celebrate the remarkable contribution of Nagaland and the Nagas in the journey of our great nation thus far. While we wonder at the achievements that we have made, we are also always reminded of the very exceptional kind of situation that our state and the people face all alone. As a part
of this great nation, we continue to be in pursuit of the final solution of the Naga political issue, which remains as old
as this nation itself. Our hope has risen to a great extent as in recent years we have seen magnificent forward movement on this issue. The Naga political groups have been in ceasefire with Government of India for a long time, and the peace talks over the years have made significant progress. It has been possible to understand each other's position and reach a broad consensus on most of the issues. The Naga people sincerely appreciate the Government of India for recognizing the unique history and position of the Naga people and for acknowledging the problem as a political issue. The state government has, over the past years, played a role of active facilitator to the ongoing Indo-Naga political peace talks. We gave further impetus to the peace talks and helped arrive at the final solution at the earliest.
We have formed the Parliamentary Committee on Naga political issue, consisting of all members of the Nagaland Legislative Assembly and
our two
honorable members of Parliament. We have also constituted a core committee to ensure a focused approach in our role as facilitator. The core committee has appealed to the negotiating parties to move forward with a positive approach of mutual respect and set aside preconditions in the greater interest of the people's tribe for long-term peace. We have also appealed to all Naga political groups to make serious efforts towards unity and reconciliation. Listening to the voice of the people, all the elected members of the 13th Nagaland Legislative Assembly have come together, irrespective of political party affiliations, on the political Naga political issue and of people's issue. Taking the spirit of collectiveness further in the recent concluded session of the
Nagaland Legislative Assembly, the members unanimously passed a resolution appealing to the negotiating parties on the same line as resolved by the core committee. The House appealed to the Naga political negotiation groups to come together in order to hammer out their differences and give the people an inclusive solution which is honorable and acceptable. We have a long-standing interstate border dispute with our neighbor Assam. There were some recent tense situations along the Assam-Nagaland border. We took proactive steps along with Assam government to de-escalate the situation. A select committee of the House has been constituted to examine all aspects of the Nagaland-Assam border issue. We feel that the border issue should be settled amicably by the two states involving local communities from both sides. Dear friends, as we celebrate this Independence Day, we also reflect on the very tough situation that we have gone through this year, along with the rest of the country and the world, on account of the second wave of COVID-19 pandemic. The ferocity of the second wave of pandemic has tested our capabilities and capacities and our resilience, but we have made efforts to combat the pandemic successfully. We took preventive measures in time and we moved swiftly to augment our health infrastructures, particularly the availability of oxygen across the state, the most critical elements in the fight against COVID-19. From modest oxygen facilities last year, we now have 6 functional PSA oxygen plants with a daily capacity of 3.7 metric tons. And another 19 plants are under installation in various district hospitals and some community health centers. We have now a total of 1,816 oxygen concentrators and 6,082 oxygen cylinders of various capacities. We have provided equipment to government as well as private health facilities so that sufficient oxygen support beds, including ICU and HDU beds, are available to meet any emergency besides the 3 BSL laboratories. We have also established 25 TrueNet and 362 rapid antigen testing facilities for COVID-19 across the state. We also building a 200-bedded hospital for acute medical care in CIHR, Dimapur, which is likely to get operational in a week's time from now. This hospital will get operational in a few weeks' time, and this hospital, in a short run, will also be inavailable for our people, including children, should there be a third wave of COVID-19. Despite the best efforts put by everyone concerned, however, there have been cases of people succumbing due to COVID-19. Our heart goes out to all such families who lost their near and dear ones, and we pray for giving them strength to bear the irreparable loss that they had suffered. We further appeal to all citizens of the state to continue to observe COVID appropriate behavior in all times.
It is also our appeal to all eligible persons to take the vaccine, not only in your personal interest, but in the greater interest of your family and the community. We commend all those villages which have made extra efforts to get 100% of their residents protected by taking vaccines. We are hopeful that the remaining villages will also proactively work for getting this 100% vaccination status. We take this opportunity to pay tribute and extend our deepest appreciation to all the health workers and frontline workers in the state and across the world for the enormous sacrifices that they have made for the cause of humanity. While appreciating the civil societies, organizations, the churches, the village authorities, and all citizens of the state for the excellent lockdowns and steps to protect the citizens of the state. Let us remind ourselves that our conduct, behavior, and safety precautions will largely determine the level of impact in the event of any further wave. Therefore, let us continue to be vigilant and work collectively as one united force against this global pandemic. We are all in it together, and each citizen is a member of Team Nagaland. Together we are stronger, and collectively we will surely triumph. The COVID-19 pandemic and the lockdowns required to check the spread of
infection have made us realize the importance of building the skill of our people and making them self-reliant to earn their livelihood. The government has therefore focused on strengthening of again the life sector, skills and service sectors, trade and commerce with four key objectives, namely self-reliance, reskilling, gainful employment and facilitation. Even as the nation joins together to celebrate our 75th year of freedom, it is most appropriate that we all congratulate the Indian contingents at the recently concluded Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games for a remarkable performance. Our girls and boys of Team India came back with a record haul of medals. And the achievement of Manish Chopra inspired
the whole country. The performance of the hockey teams
and all other medal winners brought joy and happiness to more than a billion Indians and lifted the mood of the entire nation. We congratulate and thank all the athletes and the support staff for doing India proud. And it would be incomplete if we do not mention the commendable performance of the other Olympians
who could not win medals. Every member of the Indian team performed exceptionally well, and I'm sure Indian sport is now on the rise. Dear friends,
on this 75th Independence Day, let us take a pledge to rededicate ourselves to work sincerely for bringing positive developments in all these areas where we are still lagging behind, so that Nagaland soon gets counted among the most developed and progressive states of our country. It is our dream and our inspiration to take Nagaland forward
progressive manner.
And I look forward to the cooperation and participation of all our citizens, especially the youth, in our common quest to make Nagaland a much better place for the present and future generations. Let us all put our best efforts to make Nagaland shine brighter and work towards a Nagaland where peace and security prevails, where an atmosphere and platform is provided to our youth to have equal opportunities and compete with the rest of the country and the world. A society powered by economic growth with a thriving atmosphere of creativity and innovation, with the constant flowering of human spirit in the terms of human endeavor. I once again convey greetings on the occasion of the country Independence Day to all citizens of the state and to all Indians across the globe. May the country continue to grow and may it continue to make positive contributions toward the progress of humanity everywhere. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, we shall now commence with the presentation of awards. This is for announcement. On the occasion of Independence Day 2021, the President's Police Medal for Distinguished Service is awarded to Sri K. Martin Pioneer, IGP, INT, Kohima, Nagaland. Police Medal for Meritorious Service is awarded to Sri Vikosa Chapasang, NPS Commandant, 10th NAP IR Battalion, Zadima. Union Home Minister's Medal for Excellence in Investigation for the year 2021 is awarded to Sri Tim Siyangba, UBSI CP, Dimapur, Nagaland.
On the occasion of Independence Day 2021, the recipient of Governor's Gold Medal are as follows.
Sri Tim Siyangba, UBSI, Commissioner of Police, Dimapur. Sri Tekunal Yore, DPO, Woka. Engineer Nirei Lisa, EE, Office of the Chief Engineer, PHED. Sri M. Roland Dotta, Chief Operating Officer, Programs, NSRLNRD Department. Sri T. Atoy Yanlev, NPS, Additional SP Mom. We shall now begin with the presentation of awards. President's Correctional Service Medal for Meritorious Service as announced on Independence Day 2020. Sri K. Amtok Pong, Superintendent of Jail, District Jail, Twinsang, Nagaland. He is awarded the President's Correctional Service Medal for Meritorious Service for his initiatives to reform the inmates by imparting skill development and vocational short-term activities and poultry farming to encourage the inmates to sustain livelihood after release from jail.
The following are the Governor's Gold Medal awardees as announced on Independence Day 2020. The first recipient is Sri Shanawaz C., IAS Principal Director, Directorate of School Education, Nagaland. He is awarded the Governor's Gold Medal for proving his mettle as an administrator and manager in introducing many bold initiatives which have positively impacted the education system in the state. The next recipient is Sri S. Ketoshe Sumi, Havaldar DES Umagum. He is awarded the Governor's Gold Medal for exhibiting his outstanding zeal, efficiency, courage, and sacrifice while performing law and order duties in the state, as well as tackling antisocial elements. Our next recipient is Rattle and Hum Music Society, NGO, Kohima, Nagaland. They are awarded the Governor's Gold Medal for promoting music and arts on several levels, beginning from grassroots up to world-renowned arenas on international platform.
Recipient of Governor's Gold Medal,
as announced on Republic Day 2021. First, Engineer Visotio Senator, EEPWD R&D, South Division, Kohima.
He is awarded Governor's Gold Medal for his untiring service in improvement of Kohima City Roads, 4-lane RCC Sonoru Bridge, and his relentless effort to clear the roads during monsoon season. Secondly, Engineer Talitam Sejambiam, EEPWD R&B, Dimapur Division. He is awarded the Governor's Gold Medal for his capability in improvement of Dimapur City Roads and completion of RCC, Gadar Bridge
over Chapi and Dansuri River.
Srimati Elika Jumomi, NCS, SDOC, MON. She is awarded the Governor's Gold Medal for efficiently delivering her assigned duties and also for conceptualizing and implementing various innovative activities for people's welfare.
Following are the Governor's Commendation Certificate awardees. Our first recipient is Engineer Vimite Tusa, SDO under EEPWD Roads and Bridges South Division, Kohima. He awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate for his excellent service in various technical issues and in improvement of Kohima City roads and the completion of the Sonoru Bridge. Next recipient is Engineer Lagashi Su, SEO under EEPWD, Roads and Bridges Development Division. He is awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate for his dedication in improvement of Dimapur City roads and the completion in time of RCC Girder Bridge over Dhansiri River at Nagarjan Kuda Village. Next recipient is Engineer Muzivoi Ringa, SDO under EEPWD Roads and Bridges Dimapur Division. He is awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate for contributing his time and energy in achieving the improvement of Dimapur City roads and completion of RCC girder bridge over Chate River Dipapar behind Referral Hospital. The next recipient is Sri Lalwakam Chang, ADSI Tent NAB IR Battalion. He is awarded the Honours Commendation Certificate for exhibiting high level of professional leadership in apprehending 4 underground cadres along with arms and ammunition at Taitang Nala while escaping after killing a person at Tuen Sang Town.
Next, we have Srimati Tuboni Tukru, UBSI INT.
She is awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate for her conspicuous gallantry and intrepidity at the risks of her life above and beyond the call of duty, which has led to solve a number of complex cases. Next, Sri
Abemo Vezu, Paveldar, Narcotic Cell, PhD. He is awarded the Governor's Commendation
Certificate for his remarkable experience in his assigned duties, which has led to the detection of numerous cases of banned narcotic substances.
Next, we have Tepuzo Chakisan, Paveldar, DEF PEC. He is awarded the Governor's
Commendation Certificate for displaying exemplary courage by arresting hardcore extortionists and kidnappers, even at the cost of his life, thereby sending a strong signal to the antisocial elements that no one is above law and will face befitting punishment.
Our next recipient is Sri Iti Lubzak, Subdivisional Agri Officer, SDAO, Daluki Perin. He is awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate for significantly contributing in creating his own innovative modules of training and in modifying and improving agricultural tools and machineries to suit local conditions and usages. Our next recipient is Sri M. Akweba Imchongchongar, Chokidara Directorate of Art and Culture, Nagaland. He is awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate for his distinguished service, remarkable devotion to duty, and for demonstrating extraordinary commitment in his line of duty. Next recipient is Sri Masatuba Nongkumar, PM, Directorate of Rural Development, Nagaland. He is awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate in recognition of his outstanding and dedicated service and his willingness to carry out any task entrusted to him even beyond the call of duty.
The next recipient is Srimati K. Nongmong Koyak, UDA, Deputy Commissioner Office, Mong.
She is awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate for trustworthiness, reliability, and positive attitude towards work, which act as a motivation for juniors and co-workers.
The next recipient is Srimati Virosa, Constable 15 NAP IR Mahila Batali.
She is awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate for displaying her most selfless valor in single-handedly apprehending an armed driver while performing traffic duty at Green Park, Dimapur.
Next recipient is Sri Temsil Langumar, Horticulture Officer, Dimapur. He is awarded the Governor's Commendation Certificate for his leadership skills in dragging his team of officials towards bigger heights of success in implementing various central and state programs. Next, Dr. Visobol Mekro, Principal, Pak Dorman College.
He is awarded Governor's Commendation Certificate in recognition of his creative leadership, managerial skills, which has brought tremendous changes and major improvement in the academic field.
Today, we appreciate all healthcare workers whose continuous and strenuous efforts have resulted in 3 villages, 1 colony in Kohima town, achieving 100% COVID-19 vaccination of eligible beneficiaries. The certificate for appreciation in recognition of achieving 100% COVID-19 vaccination of eligible beneficiaries are Visuma village under Jakama block. Sichuma village under Sichuma block. Zubzabla village under Sichuma block. And finally, we have New Minister's Hill Colony, Kohima Town. And ladies and gentlemen, with that, we've come to the end of the presentation of awards.
Deputy Commandant 10, NFP IR, Parrot 2 IC, Srimati Madam Kala Tudir, Assistant Commandant 15, NFP IR. First Assam Rifle Battalion, led by Platoon Commander Naik Subedar Vinod Kumar.
Hello.
78th CRPF Battalion, led by Platoon Commander Inspector P.S. Pujuri. 37th DSF, led by Platoon Commander S.I. Anil Kumar. 4th NAP Battalion,
led by Platoon Commander, MPSI, Tasel Akan.
2nd Brass Band, PDS, led by Pan Master, MPSI, not a ball bully. 10th NAP IR Battalion, led by Platoon Commander, ABSI Chibolo Matthew. 14 Assam Rifles Fight Band, led by Band Master Avalar Mahidev Singh Rawat.
Yeah.
Next, we have All to My Motherland, Top My Initiatives. The song was composed specially for the 75 years of India's independence by Mahotsav. I request the next performer to get ready. Thank you.
Thank you.
sing traditional songs and dance the entire day. The songs and dance relate to past days of valor, unity, bravery, and victory. For the revelry of music and dance, the men and women of the community wear traditional attires.
Followed by the beating of the tree.